Hello all, welcome to the third session of the module 4. So in the previous session, we had seen the design of mod 6 synchronous up counter. Today, we'll try to see the design of mod 8 synchronous counter using SR flip-flop. Here also, we'll see the up counter design. Okay, it is mod 8. Mod 8 means 0 to 7. Largest number being the 7, it includes 3 bits, minimum 3 bits to represent 7, so 3 flip-flops. So up counter in sequence from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 8, 0. So the sequence goes on. Okay. But here we are designing this mod 8 synchronous up counter using SR flip-flop. So that is the only change that we have done. Two changes. One is mod 6 to mod 8. And using JK, we are now designing using SR flip-flop, and the corresponding excitation table for the SR flip-flop is shown here. Okay. So if I have a transition from present state 0 to next state 0, it is 0, don't care. 0 to 1 means 1, 0. 1 to 0 is 0, 1, and 1 to 1 is don't care 0. Okay. And this is how the state diagram of mod 8 up counter looks like. 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then back to 0. Okay, this is what we have. So again, as I said, when we are designing a synchronous counter, we are interested in the present state. We are interested in basically the present state, then the next state. Okay. So here, as I said, different textbook uses different notations. Here I have taken one of the flip-flop as A0, another flip-flop as A1, and another as A2. Okay. So if the current state of the counter is 0, 0, 0, means next is 1. If it is 1, means 2. If the present state is 2, 3. 3 means next 4. 4 means next 5. 5 means next 6. 6 means next 7. 7 means back to 0. Okay. And the moment I know the present state and the next state, now I have to find the inputs for the SR flip-flop, since we are designing the synchronous counter using SR flip-flop. Okay. So S and R inputs of A2 flip-flop, S and R inputs of A1, S and R inputs of A0. Okay. So in order to find out the inputs of for S and R, I'm interested in A2 and A2 plus. Okay. To find the S and R inputs of A2, I'm interested in the present state of A2 and A2 plus. Okay. So again, present state of A2 is 0, next state of 0 is 0, don't care. Okay. So similarly, 0 to 0 is 0, don't care. 0 to 0 again, 0, don't care. 0 to 1 is 1, 0. 1 to 0, don't care, 0. So you just complete the S and R column with respect to A2, seeing the present state of A2 and the next state of A2 plus. Next, to find the values of presence S and R inputs of A1 flip-flop, I am interested in the present state of 1 and the next state of A1 plus. Okay. So to get the S and R of A1 flip-flops, I'm interested in A1 and the A1 plus next state. Okay. 0, 0, it is 0, don't care. Next it is 0, 1, it is 1, 0. Next it is something like 1, 1, it is don't care 0. And it keeps on going with respect to the present state and the next state. Okay. So you can just enter with respect to the excitation. And finally, to find out the S and R of A0 flip-flop, I'm interested in A0 of the present state A0 and the next state A0 plus, or A0 bar they call. Both are one and the same now. Okay. So again, checking with the present state and next state. Present state of A0 is 0. Next state of A0 is 1. 0, 1 means it is 1, 0. Present state is 1. Next state is 0. It is 0, 1. Okay. Present state is 0. Next state is 1, it is 1, 0. So we have an alternate 1, 0, 0, 1 combination. Correspondingly, we fill all these things. Okay. So this is about the present state, next state, and the SR flip-flop inputs, which we call it as a transition table. And as we know, once we are done with the present, the transition table, next is we have to find out the expression for S and R of A2 flip-flop, S and R of A1 flip-flop, and S and R of A0 flip-flop. Similarly, have to use KMap or Karnaugh map in getting the expression for this. How many variable KMap? That depends upon the present state. How many present state? Three present states are with respect to A0, A1, A2. So correspondingly, I will have three variable KMap each to be used to find out S, R of all the flip-flops. So here we have entered the values accordingly. Okay. So with respect to for A0, 0, 0, 0, my S is 0 for A2 flip-flop, and that is what I have implemented. So similarly, I will fill all these things. Okay. And then get the minimum grouping in each KMap. Okay. In this only one is there. So I have A2 bar A1 A0 for S input of A2. Similarly, for R input of A2, only this, it is A2 A1 A0. And when I go for grouping in terms of SA1, okay, it is this grouping I do. It is A1 bar A0. And for RA1, it is again A1 A0. For SA0, it is A0 bar. And for RA0, it is A0. Okay. So I could find S and R inputs of A2 flip-flop, S and R inputs of A1 flip-flop, S and R inputs of A0 flip-flops from the given present state and the SR inputs. Okay. Once I have all the expression, next is take the three flip-flops corresponding to each. This is A2 flip-flop, this is A1 flip-flop, whereas this is A0 flip-flop. So this is SA0, this is RA0. So whatever the expression you have got for SA0 and RA0, you can connect it there. So whatever the expression you have got for SA1 and RA1, that combination logic you apply. Similarly, whatever the expression you got for SA2 and RA2, okay, that combination looks like. Okay. So this is the logic diagram of mod 8 synchronous counter using SR flip-flops. Okay. So we have seen the mod 6 synchronous up counter, mod 8 synchronous up counter till this point. Okay. Next, as I said, sometimes the sequence may be in order, increment, but need not always the counter or the synchronous counter or counting to be in any specific order. Okay. Here is an example of design of synchronous counter using T flip-flop for the sequence. You can see that there is a different sequence here. Okay. That means 0, next is 2, 3, 6, 5, 1, 0. Again, it should count 2, 3, 6, 5, 1, 0, something like that. Okay. So we call this as something like arbitrary counter. I don't have any sequence here. Okay. That's why we call it as arbitrary sequence. Need not be any increasing or decreasing. This is an arbitrary sequence, or sometimes you call it as arbitrary synchronous counter. Okay. So again, the design remains the same. I should have the present state and the next state. But you should know that if my present state is 0, 0, 0, after 0, what is my next state? 2. So in the next state of the present state 0, 0, 0, I should have 2 here. This is my 0. This is my 2. Okay. Present state 0 means next state 2. If the present state is 2 means that is 0, 1, 0, next state has to be 3. Because I am following this. Okay. From 2, it is go to 3. And from 3, it should go to 6. If the present state is 3 means next state is 6. 1, 1, 0 is basically 6 in decimal. Similarly, if the present state is 6, next we are going to 5. Okay. If the present state is 5, next state is 1. If the present state is 1, next state is 0. Okay. This is what? So 0, 2, 3, 6, 5, 1, 0. Only thing is the next state and the present state will change. Okay. And always make sure whenever you are designing a synchronous counter, there is always a row-wise relation with respect to the present state and the next state. That is very important. Okay. And now, again, the largest number in this sequence is 6. Minimum 3 bits to represent 6, so 3 flip-flop. That's why pre-present state. And now we have to design this using T flip-flop. And T flip-flop basically has only one input. So three flip-flops we are taking, T1, T2, and T3. Okay. So T1 being the MSB, T3 being the MSB. And the excitation table for T flip-flop is this. If the present state and next state is zero, it is zero. Or you can say that if the present state and next state are same, the T input is zero. If they are different, T input is one. Okay. So to find out the T1 input values, I'm interested in Q1 and Q1 plus. Okay. 0 to 0 is 0. 0 to 0 is 0. 0 to 1, both are different, it is 1. So you fill out in the similar fashion for T2 as well as T3. Okay. So T2 with respect to Q2 and Q2 plus. Again, one or two example I'll take. Present state 0, next state 1. So output is 1. That is the T2 input is 1. Sorry. If the present state is 1, next state is 1. If the present state and next state both are same, input is 0. If they're same, input is 0. If they are different, input is 1. If they are same, input is 0. If they are different, same, input is 0. Okay. So similarly, you find out the input values for T3 with respect to Q3 and Q3 plus column. That is the present state and the next state. See the present state and the next state and the corresponding T3 input based on my excitation table. Okay. So this is an arbitrary counting sequence, which is again, I can call it as a mod 6, but with the sequence different, 0, 2, 3, 6, 5, 1, 0. Okay. This is what I have. And once I have this flip-flop inputs and the present state, I have to find out the expression for T1, T2, and T3. Okay. So again, I need require K-map. How many variable K-map? That depends upon the present state. There are three present states. So again, three variable K-map. Okay. So with that, we'll go for this. Okay. So three variable corresponding to T0, Q1, Q2, Q3. I just keep on entering my thing. So how exactly? So for 0, 0, 0, 0, T1 is 0. And that's what we have entered over here. Okay. For 0, 1, 0, that is 2, cell 2, I have to enter 0. Where is cell 2? This is cell 2, I have entered 0. Okay. For cell 3, it is 1. 3 is 1. For cell 3, it is 1. We have already seen. For cell 6, it is 0. Cell 6 is 0. So you should be very careful if it is, when it is not a in sequence counter. Okay. It is an arbitrary counter. Okay. You just fill out, then you get the corresponding groups. Okay, I want to have a minimum groups. One with don't care, one with don't care. Remaining anyhow, we have either the dash is this. Basically, it is nothing but what don't care. Okay, some they indicate dash, some they indicate D, some they indicate X. So I'll just take this as something like don't care. Okay, that will be easy for us to. So two groups, one for this, one for this. I get T1 as Q1, Q3 plus Q2, Q3. T3 as this. Q2 plus Q3 Q1 bar, T2 as Q1 Q2 plus Q1. This is Q2 Q3. This is Q2 bar, Q3 bar. Just this 2 and 3, they have gone a little bit this side. That's an okay. I can manage. Okay. So this is Q2 bar and Q3. So this is T2 is OR operation between Q1 Q2 and Q2 bar Q3 bar. T1 is an OR operation between Q1 Q3 and Q2 Q3. T3 is an OR operation between Q2 and Q3 Q1 bar. The moment I have these three expressions, okay, I can go for drawing the logic diagram using T flip-flop. There are three flip-flops that is required. Okay. 1, 2, and 3. And the corresponding inputs for T1, T3 with respect to the combination logic. So this is the T1. Okay. This is the T2. And this is my T3. T3 is nothing but what? Q2 into Q3, Q1 bar, and that is what I'm having. If you want, you can just check with this. Q2 plus Q3, Q1 bar. So T3 is basically Q2 OR with Q3, Q1 bar. Okay, so this is what, this is the logic diagram that we get from this particular expression values for T1, T3, and T2 for the transition table of this particular design. Okay, so this is about mod 6 synchronous counter using T flip flop for the sequence 0 2 3 6 5 1 0. Okay, next again same thing, mod 6, same means the sequence is remaining the same, but the only thing is we are changing the flip flop. So now it is SR flip flop, but for the sequence 0, you can see that 0, next is 2. If I'm in 2, next is 3. If the present state is 3, next state is 6. For the present state 6, next state 5. If the present state 5, next state is 1. If the present state is 1, next state is 0. Okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is what? Okay, the sum sequence 0, 2, 3, 6, 5, 1, 0. Okay. So this is what we are having. Okay. Okay, I can't say this is mod 6. I can simply say that don't consider this to be a mod 6. When I say mod 6, I have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But here, there is no 4 in this. So I can simply say this is a design of arbitrary synchronous counter. Okay, design of arbitrary okay synchronous counter with this sequence. Yeah, this is what I am. So present state, next state, you know, and now it is the SR, using SR flip flop I have to design, and correspondingly I have an excitation table of SR flip flop. Okay, so to find out the first flip flop S and R inputs, I am interested in Q1 and Q1 plus. 0 to 0, it is 0 don't care, or 0 hyphen what we have. Okay, 0 to 0 is 0 dash, 0 to 1 is 1 0. Similarly, 1 to 1 is dash 0 something. So you can fill out corresponding to S2 R2 with respect to Q2 and Q2 plus column, and S3 R3 with respect to Q3 and Q3 plus. Okay. So once I fill out all these things, okay, I will get what is my S1, S2, similarly R2, S1, R2. S1, S2, R3, S3. Okay. So I can get each and every expression with respect to S1, S2, R2. Okay. So you can similarly with respect to the previous one. Okay. So again, how many variable Kmap? It is a 3 variable Kmap, Q1, Q2, Q3. Okay. So I have to find out the expression for S1. Okay. So Q1 being the MSP, Q3 being the LSP. So you can see that from the previous, for 0 minterm, my S1 is 0. That's why I've entered 0 over here. For 2, it is 0. Okay. Similarly, for 3, it is 1. You can see that for 3, it is 1. For 6, it is hyphen. For 6, it is hyphen. Similarly, complete all these things. Okay. And when it grouping comes, hyphen is nothing but what the don't care we are using. I have a one group, and this is Q2, Q3. Similarly, find out S2, S1, S2, R1, R2, R3, and S3 correspondingly. Once we get all the expression, I can find you what is the expression for S1, R1, S1, R1, S2, R2, and S3. This is all about the logic diagram. Yeah. So this is S1 is basically Q2, Q3. R1 is basically Q2 bar directly you give. Okay. Then I have S2 as S2, whatever the input I am giving for S2 is the AND operation between Q3 bar, Q1 bar. And R2 is simply Q1. And then S3 is the combination AND operation of Q2 and Q3 bar that I am giving. R1 is the AND operation of Q1, Q3 bar. Okay. And since it is a synchronous counter, common clock is given for all. Okay. So this is how exactly we try to design the synchronous counter. Okay. So in the next session, we'll see the sequential network. And before that, the last one in this particular counter design is the self-correcting codes. There are other types of counters like self-correcting counters, or also can be designed in which a new states can be sent to some common states. Meaning, till now, for example, if I take this expression itself, I have 0, 2, 3, 6, 5, 1, 0. Okay, 4 and 7 are missing in this particular. Okay, so this is what the sequence I have: 0, 2, 3, 6, 5, and 1, and finally again it is 0. Okay. When I use 3 bits, again the largest number being 3, it requires 3 bits of information. 3 bits. To represent 6. Okay. So using 3 bits, I can have 0, 0, 0 to 7. 1, 1, 1. 0 is a valid state. 1 is a valid state in this. 2 is a valid state in this. 3 is a valid state in this. 4 is not there in the sequence. 4 is not there in the sequence. 5, yes, it is there. Sorry. 5 is valid. 6 is a valid. 7 is not a valid. Okay. This is what I am. Using 3 bits, I can have count from 0 to 7. But in our design, assume that we have designed a synchronous counter with the sequence 0, 2, 3, 6, 5, 1, 0, and then the sequence continues. But what if during counting, the counter goes to this state, invalid state 1000. If I have not specified what is the next state of this, then I think the counter never goes to any other counting sequence. Okay, so that's why what we have to do is, whenever you have an invalid or not a valid state, always mention the invalid state, next state to be any one of the valid state. In this case, the 4 next state they have specified as 2, the 7 next case next state they have specified as one of the valid state 101. Okay, or any invalid states are there, or any states which are not used in the sequence, always specify the next state of the invalid state to be any one of the valid states, and that we call it as a self-correcting course. For example, if I want to go back and see in the previous cases, okay, what exactly I mean by, yes, see here, 0 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 1, 1 to 0. Okay, I am not used to 4 and 6 here, because 7, because they are not there in the sequence. Okay, but using 3 bits, I can have total 8 numbers, 0 to 7. Out of 8, only 6 are used, two have not been used. That one is the 4 and another is the 7. Suppose if my counter by some means, okay, by some means, it goes to this state, which is nothing but what? 4. And in this design, we have not specified what is the next state of 4. So the counter, even though you are giving a continuous pulses, clock pulses and all, it will never know that after 4 where it has to go. Even if not 4, if somehow it has, or it somehow this counter goes to this state 111, again it doesn't know where exactly to go. So that's why in this particular example, they have given 0, 2, 3, 6, 5, 1, 0. Always make sure in a self, what exactly we mean by self-correcting codes means, in the present state you include the invalid state also. Invalid means in this particular example, 4 and 7 are not a valid state for me. That's why I'm saying it as an invalid present state. But still, I write my invalid present state in this particular column only, just to make sure that if the counter by somehow gets into this invalid state, I specify the next state of this to be any one of the valid state. Any one of the valid state means I can, the next state of 4 may be 0, the next state of 4 may be 2, 3, 6, whatever. You can specify anything. So now I'll just simply specify 2. For 7, I may specify 5. It can be anything. The moment I specify 7 to 5 means, assume that counter goes and sits in this invalid, and now it has a transition from invalid state to 5. And 5 as an invalid state to what? 1. Okay. So always make an invalid state, next state to be always a valid present state to overcome any of the problems. Okay. So, and whenever you do that, we call that as something as a self-correcting code. Okay. There are other types of counters like self-correcting counters, which are also can be designed in which a new states can be used, sent to some common states. A new state can be sent to some common used states. I was saying invalid state, they are the unused states sent to use. You can, okay. So that's what, this is an example for that. Yeah. So we'll try to stop here in this session. And in the next session, we'll take up the sequential network or sequential circuit, in which we'll discuss about the Mealy and the Moore sequential network. Thank you.